Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be discussing the types of contraction that can occur at muscle. And specifically, we are going to focus on the types of phasic muscle contraction or active contraction, but we will touch on other types of contraction like reflexive or tonic contractions because they do certainly play an important role in the musculoskeletal system. So there'll be two main types of the phasic contractions. An isometric contraction, which you can see being illustrated here, is one of these types. And this is the contraction that I wager most of us don't think about as much. And the key to isometric contraction, as in all contractions, is that there is force and muscle tension, and this force is increased above the tonic or muscle tone levels, and energy is certainly being expended. But what is unique to isotonic contraction is that no movement occurs, and the muscle length will remain the same. This image makes it look like it changes just a little bit, but it does, which isn't true. There'll be no change in terms of length, but you can see that there is no movement occurring with this type of contraction. The function of isometric contraction is mainly to resist gravity or other antagonistic forces, and is particularly important in postural muscles. The other major type of contraction is isotonic contraction, and this is the type of muscle contraction where muscle does change in some form and length, and there is movement. So those are kind of the two keys. There's a change in length, and there's a change in movement, or movement is occurring. The two major types of isotonic contraction are concentric and eccentric contractions. Concentric contraction is usually the type of contraction that we think of when we're thinking of muscle contractions. In fact, when we talk about the individual muscles and we start listing the actions of that muscle, we are discussing what actions occur when that muscle is concentrically contracting. So this one, not that it's more important, it's just more of what we think of when we're thinking of contractions. With this type of contraction, the muscle will shorten, and that's kind of key. So it's going to, the muscle will shorten in size, and it will cause some form of movement, particularly a type of movement that will reduce the angle at a joint. Eccentric contraction is kind of the opposite of that. This is going to cause a muscle to lengthen. Lengthen is kind of the key here. In other words, a muscle will have a controlled and kind of gradual relaxation while still exerting an ever-diminishing amount of force. So you can see that it is kind of stretching in terms of the muscle shape. So stretching or lengthening, and you can see that there is movement being caused. As I mentioned at the beginning, there are other types of contraction. Reflexive contraction, these are not voluntarily controlled, which is unique for skeletal muscle. We know that because we know that based on previous videos that skeletal muscle is supposed to be voluntarily controlled. But there are some exceptions to the rule, and where some skeletal muscle will have reflexive or more automatic contractions. So for example, the diaphragm, or our main muscle of respiration, or inspiration, excuse me, is this a skeletal muscle, and we typically aren't consciously contracting that one. So there'll be some reflexive contraction associated with the diaphragm. Tonic contraction is a very, and I mean very, slight contraction that does not produce movement. So this is not going to be isometric contraction, which doesn't produce movement either. It's going to be on an even smaller scale in terms of the amount of tension that occurs with the muscle. And tonic contractions occur all the time in almost all muscles. So even when a muscle is relaxed, there is a small, often unnoticeable amount of contraction, actually very often unnoticeable amount of contraction, and we call this muscle tone. Do I have that written down? Yeah, right here. That's an important thing here. So that's called muscle tone. Functions of tonic contractions include stability of joints and maintenance of posture. And muscle tone can be lost. It can be lost in nerve lesions or damage that result in muscle paralysis. or when an individual is unconscious. All right, so those are the main types of contraction. Let's review a concept together. Question. When a muscle stretches, i.e. Muscle lengthening, what type of contraction is this? So let's look at this question stem. What are some of the keys here? Well, I see muscle stretches. That's telling me something. I think this is helpful. Ooh, muscle lengthening. That's super helpful. Which answer choice would you think best describes this? Eccentric. Yes, correct. B is correct. It is not concentric because muscles will shorten, not lengthen. And isometric will have no change in shape. Same thing with tonic, but tonic, of course, is on a much smaller scale than the isometric with contraction. So all that leaves is eccentric or B as the correct answer. Excellent. That was a lot of fun. As always, as you review this or any other material, please feel free to reach out with any questions and have a great rest of your day.